I'm Giuseppe Mastandrea, and I will briefly present our project and its result. After my presentation, as said by Zian, considering that the project is really close to the end, we have decided to present a demo of one of the services developed in our project. Professor Tudor Shoara of Technical University of Cluj-Napoca will present the demo. eDream project is a project funded in LCE program of European Commission, and the duration of our project is 36 months. The end of the project is expected at the end of the year, but probably due to the spread of COVID-19 in Europe, the Commission will grant it as 6 months of extensions. The contribution of the European Community is around of 4 million euros. The coordinator of our project is Engineering Ingegneria Informatica Italia ICT Company, and in our consortium are present different partners from Italy, Greece, Romania, Spain, and UK. In particular, as ICT players, solution provider, Engineering Atos and EnergetWork, as energy stakeholders, ASM, a local DSO interni in Italy, Kiwi Power, an energy aggregator of UK, Emotion is Italian aggregators, and Servalet is a Romanian ESCO. And also partner for the Academy, Technical University of Cluj-Napoca, CERT, that is a Greek center of research, and the Teesside University. We have three pilots for the validation. In particular, we are in the validation phase of our project, and in particular, we are implementing a lab-based validation of the technologies and tools developed in our project in Thessaloniki, in the demo lab of CERT. And we are validating a solution for secure microgrid environment for participation in blockchain-driven demand response programs interni in ASM, that is already said, DSO of Terni, and we are exploiting the network of customers of English aggregator Kiwi Power for the integration of smart customers, their asset management, and the demand response network planning validation. The objective of our project is the deployment of solution for demand response that consider virtual power plants as well as decentralized approaches towards achieving a reduction in peak grid demand and real savings for the final customer. What we have done, we have implemented different components, different services, and in particular, we are demonstrating a closed-loop demand response framework designed to maintain the real-time balance of supply and demand in the centralized environment. In particular, the different technologies and services developed in eDream has been grouped in three macro groups: the techniques for demand response and energy flexibility assessment, for which we have developed the modeling and forecasting for electricity and virtual power plants, baseline techniques for baseline flexibility estimation, and also through the use of drone, multi-building demand response characterization through thermal, optical, linear information fusion for demand response aerial survey. We have developed next generation demand response services for aggregators and customers. In particular, we have developed decision making tool, PV, RES, degradation and trend analysis, tools for big data clusterings, for load profiling and customer segmentation, and visualization platform based on graph analytics. We have also developed some services based on blockchain for the control and optimization of the decentralized network and MR response verification that we will present in the second part of our presentation through a demo. In this slide is reported the idea behind our project. In particular, this idea is well represented, that is the development of a closed loop demand response environment that incorporates novel near real-time demand response verification assessment mechanisms and services, and is able to involve all the interest actors, from the prosumers to the involvement in energy marketplace by means of blockchain-based technologies, and also for the evaluation of their PV plant and the estimation of flexibility, and for the pre-assessment in order to participate in the services provided by the aggregator. We have developed also for the aggregator instrument for district management, for modeling and forecasting district, and to provide to DSO the energy flexibility provided by the prosumers to solve the problem related to the congestion point. Instrument for DSO has been developed, such as big data clustering, interactive visualization, and decision-making toolset. At this point, in this slide is present the status of the project. As already mentioned, we are very close to the end of the project. In particular, we have defined all the requirements of the project through a specific project process of involvement and engagement of stakeholders in the first phase through organization of several workshop, webinar, and conference in which we have submitted to the stakeholders different questionnaires. On the basis of, we have defined the services and the architecture. We have developed all the solution expected in our architecture. In June, in particular, we have finalized the development phase. We are now in the validation phase for the release of the framework and the final exploitation. At this point, I give the floor to my colleague Tudo Chorada for the demo presentation. Thank you.
Okay, so my demo, it will be based on a video. So since I cannot have a direct control of the video, I will prefer to have some explanation before of what you are about to see, and then I will talk. I will talk over the video. So the main idea of this demo is to show how blockchain and smart contracts can be used successfully used for decentralized control of flexibility, and basically leveraging on smart contracts and proof of authority as a means of assuring consensus. In this sense, we have developed smart contracts that are able to connect to the smart metering device, are able to register the information gathered from the smart metering in terms of energy consumption. They are aggregated and registered on the chain. And based on this information, the other energy players like aggregators or even the DSO is able to assess a track in real time the amount of flexibility that they are needed in order to manage successfully the grid and to assure good balance. In this sense, the main advantage brought by this technology is the fact that the control is decentralized via smart contracts, all the players in this demo will have the role as a peer, so they are able to track and assess and validate the financial statement settlement of the service on one hand, and also the settlement of energy imbalances in potential energy imbalances in the grid. Now I will ask some of the organizers to start
which one,
the
Tudor?
Video.
Which video?
The one with blockchain in its
okay.
name.
Okay, here we go.
So first is the role of a system operator. He can check the amount of energy consumption and production registered in the blockchain. He can check the forecasted values for that for production and consumption. Based on this forecasted value, he can construct flexibility requests. The flexibility requests are registered on the blockchain and automatically injected in the smart contracts that will manage the behavior of the aggregators in that microgrid. In case of aggregator, the aggregator is able to evaluate the potential of each prosumers that it's in its portfolio. So the he can check the flexibility potential as above and below the baseline. He can check the baseline of the prosumer. And then, based on the flexibility request that he had received from the operator, he's able to construct the flexibility delivery based on the portfolio and the amount of flexibility that could be aggregated from its prosumers. Using the smart contracts and the blockchain, this is automatically injected in the smart contracts of the prosumers that are regulating the behavioral prosumers. And in near real-time fashion, it is able to assess the amount of flexibility that is delivered by each individual prosumers and also the deviations from the expected amount. In terms of prosumer, so the prosumer can have multiple options. In this case, he can see its baseline and estimated flexibility potential. He can see the flexibility request injected by the aggregator in its contract. And during delivery, the monitored energy data are registered on the blockchain. And based on that information, the assessment of the deviation compared to the requirement flexibility is done in near real time, and also in near real time, the settlement of energy imbalance and also the settlement of the financial settlement of the service is being done. Okay, so this was my fast forward demo presentation.
You want to play the other one or you're finished?
No, it's okay. So I think the main idea are presented.
So there's no questions from the audience. I'm just curious, is that going to be open source or is that a commercial platform that you're the prototype that you're demoing?
It will be open source, and the demo that you have seen, it's based on the Terni pilot. So in the Terni pilot, we are testing these functionalities of having blockchain as a technology for decentralized control. Of course, there are challenges because blockchain is well known that is not that good in terms of scalability and privacy of the data, but we have managed to overcome these problems. We have developed some second tier solution, they are called, based on blockchain, that achieve very good stability, scalability, and also for the privacy of energy data. We have successfully integrated zero knowledge proofs, allowing the validation of the service to being done to be done without disclosing the energy consumption data of the prosumer.
Very cool. Thank you. There's one quick question from the audience also. How is the grid security and stability ensured in blockchain, via blockchain?
Basically, it is the stability and security it's ensured via calculating and injecting in the, so each asset of the grid is controlled via smart contract that is deployed on the blockchain. The role of the smart contract is to assess and track in real time the energy consumption or production of that asset. But also it has another great facility is the fact that via Oracle integration, we can inject what we are calling a goal signal or goal curves that allow to adapt the energy demand of that specific asset in order to meet specific targets. For example, in this pilot case, we had adapted the demand of a building. We are interacting with the building management system. We have used electrical vehicles as a source of flexibility, allowing to charge or discharge these vehicles on demand.
Wonderful. Thank you very much. Excellent presentation. Very interesting.